will ask you simple questions. You will answer in short sentences only what you believe to be absolute truth.
Absolute truth. I can do that.
I'm delighted to be here with the creative duo behind the new film Nightmare Alley, filmmaker Guillermo del Toro and co-screenwriter Kim Morgan. Great to see you both. Your new film is a noir. What are your most important classic film influences as far as films are concerned and as far as filmmakers are concerned?
One of the films I really love is Heroes for Sale by William Wellman, because it's all about a guy that comes back addicted to morphine.
But I tell you, you've got to give me some. You've got to.
I thought a lot of Stanton and like what was happening to these poor, unfortunate people that would enter the geek shows.
The thing that is important is, does the style match the needs of the movie? For example, the entrance to the carnival is exactly the entrance in Stranger on a Train. We studied Wellman and Wyler a lot. They have a camera that is beautiful, but not too showy. And I wanted to have a very curious camera, but unobtrusive.
What are some of your favorite, kind of in general, film noir tropes?
I wanted to reject everything that was or has become cliche. The fan, the Venetian blinds. When these filmmakers were making those movies, they were heavily influenced by expressionism, as was horror.
Yeah.
And that is very attractive. We try to embrace the shadows. Stan is constantly in the shadows. The cross-lining, there's always a moral moment in which the character decides, almost always wrong, and that incites the rest of the movie. Those are things I like.
I like the ambiguity, too, of the characters. So there's not, they're not completely black and white, good or bad. And it makes for a much more complex character. And even the femme fatales, they have to suffer for it in these movies, but people love watching these characters. Yes. They're very strong, interesting women.
If you displease the right people, the world closes in on you very, very fast.
We wanted to embrace the disenchantment of the post-abundance, post-depression, post-World War II era in the case of Nightmare Alley.